Hi, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Alexander of Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is your weekly astro, tarot, and intuitive forecast for the week of July 8th, 2019. Now, before I dive into the details of this video, because I can promise you it's going to be juicy, I do want to tell you that I've been stumbling and tripping over my own tongue all day. And I don't want to edit this video. I really don't. I just want to like slam bam, thank you ma'am, just kind of power through it and see what happens. So forgive my messiness in advance. That being said, we are under the influence of Mercury retrograde. Me as a Virgo, I am ruled by Mercury, so I'm under that influence tenfold. So I'm trying to slow myself down. I'm trying to pace myself, but I have a lot of energy, and this week is igniting me when I'm looking at the chart, and I'm looking at the cards, and I'm looking at my notes intuitively. I'm a little concerned, I'm not gonna lie. What is bothering me is that this week looks to be very reactive. There is a lot of emotion that is somehow being triggered by random things. It could be things that excite you, it could be things that anger you, but what I can say is that this rumbling that is happening this week that may be ignited and triggered at multiple times throughout the week, and I'll show you those days, it's something that's been kind of brewing under the surface for quite some time. I personally feel and intuitively feel that as the week goes on, this rumbling, this energy is going to get stronger and stronger and stronger, and then it's probably going to ignite in one major big way at the start of next week. I'm thinking it's the 16th, which was when we have, yes, the full moon eclipse in the sign of Capricorn. I do not think that there's negative things. I think that there's things that need to happen that can feel negative, but if we are open to them and if we're open to that change and we're not resistant to it, then we are then simultaneously open to the blessing. And as I say that, something just smacked up against my glass. Life here in New Orleans, and it made Franklin upset. So you guys heard it, Franklin heard it, and I heard it. Okay, so moving forward, that's the eclipse has a tendency to set things ablaze and set things, the lunar eclipse has a way of setting things ablaze. And also keep in mind that this week we are in the midst, the center of the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse. Now the solar eclipse kind of things into motion, but not in a way that is totally reactive. Again, this is something that's been rumbling and brewing under the surface that we may not have seen, but we kind of feel it, but we don't see it yet. So that's kind of something that I was seeing. It makes sense that it would trigger an earthquake and has triggered some earthquakes in California, because when we look at the chart, there's a lot of emphasis on the earth, the changes in our earth. And I predicted this last year. There's a lot of changes in our earth, and then there's changes in business, there's changes in government and our structure, rules, regulation, and authority figures. So not only are we seeing this eruption and this movement happening and rumbling in our ground, literally what we stand on, but we're seeing it in government and in businesses. The other thing that I want to mention is the fact that Mars, ruling our fire, our ambition, our drive, our aggression, our force, our will, is sitting in a very expressive, fiery sign of Leo. Leo is ruled by the heart. It is connected to the heart. It is the things that it is that we cannot hold back. We want to express them. And when we express it big. We express it large. We can't contain ourselves. Now, when you have Mars sitting in the sign of Leo, and then Mars squares off with Uranus, the planet of erratic change and irritability and unpredictable changes, sitting in the sign of Taurus, which rules our Earth. Taurus wants structure. It wants things that the things that it is that we value, but those things are erupting left and right. So basically what it is that we're seeing is that the safety that it is that we know and what it is that we value and what it is that we love and that we want to hold on to almost is like getting pride from our fingertips. So what are we going to do? We're going to want to fight. Then you want to look at the rest of the planets. We have Venus and Sun and now Mercury, but Mercury is now retrograde in Leo, but moving back into the sign of Cancer. So there's a lot of emphasis on the emotions and on our intuition. Why intuition? Well, because Neptune, ruling this higher knowledge, this higher seeking, this higher communication, this higher feeling, is moving through the sign of Pisces and retrograde. So it always connects us to our feelings. It always connects us to the divine, to gurus that are living here on Earth. There's two sides to every coin. So we have the gurus who are walking here on Earth, and we have those who are lying to us and lying to our faces, or you know, painting themselves to be something other than what they actually are, whether that be in the spiritual community or when it comes to love. So there's so much that is happening around us in the realm and happening underneath us that is being shook up and is very shaky and wonky and weird. And when we find out about it, because eclipses have a weird way of setting things into motion and blowing things in our face, or making us need to blow things in other people's faces and speak our truth and assert boundaries and be like, no, this is where I draw the line, or I'm forced to make this change, or I'm taking on new change in my life. When these eclipses set those things into motion, we have no choice but to respond to them, hopefully in a way that is positive and not negative. Okay, so for the overall energy of this week, I did pull cards. Of course I did, because that's the layout, the format of how I'm doing these readings now as we move forward, because you guys love the layer of intuition with science, astrology, and predictions, and I'm going to continue to give them because it's serving you and it's serving me. So the first thing that I'm seeing as the overall energy is the Queen of Pentacles and the Ace of Cups. And to me, again, this is showing that you want to ground yourself, you want to center yourself, you want to slow yourself down. For some reason, I have this vision of people kind of like sifting through and looking at what, if you scoop sand and you sift it, you're like looking to see what's in there. And it's that movement, that shakeup, that helps you to kind of like, okay, this is garbage or this is a piece of treasure. So I'm going to throw away the garbage or recycle the garbage, and I'm going to hold on to the piece of treasure. But it's that shakeup, that scoop, lift, shift, shift, shift. Oh, okay. That helps you to determine what it is that you're going to keep in your life and what is that you're going to remove. And ultimately, that is what it is that I'm seeing. I think that you would be equally surprised in both good ways and bad what it is that you find. But ultimately, you want to ground yourself and center yourself and connect with your intuition and not jump to conclusions. Because again, there's a lot of stuff here that is triggering this, okay, I want to react. What is the truth? What is reality? What is reality? It's hard to know and it's hard to find the truth. Why? Because Mercury is retrograde. A lot of things are getting kicked up. There's this illusion that's happening around us with Neptune moving through the sign of Pisces. Saturn is also retrograde. Pluto is also retrograde. There's transformation and structure that is getting restructured and kind of twisted up. And then you have these eclipses that are kicking everything up. And it's not, that's the other thing too that I want to say to you guys, is that some things that are currently are not what they will be. So what comes to you and what presents itself to you is still under a lot of change, and it's evolving and it's transforming. So if something seems like it's a curse or something seems bad, give it a week. Like literally give it a week before you make a clear-cut judgment call or before you cut something out, because a lot of people are under the same energy right now, just being, you know, pushed and putting a lot of pressure on them in order to change and to evolve in a short amount of time. So whether they know it or whether they don't know it, or if they made their mind up, that mind is most likely going to change, or things are going to present themselves that makes them want to change direction. So because things are so in flux, just keep grounding yourself and sifting and finding the truth, finding what, you know, resonates and what doesn't resonate. But the way to do that is to ground yourself and to center yourself. Now that being said, let's go ahead and move into the first chunk of this week, which covers Monday through Friday. And the cards that I pulled for that are the Tower, and then we also have the Seven of Pentacles. Now again, this is all about, okay, didn't see that coming. This is total surprise, totally unexpected. And that makes a lot of sense too, because Mars squaring off with Uranus is expect the unexpected, and it could come in like a bolt of lightning, very Tower-esque. I see this as, instead of resisting change, go with it, flow with it. You couldn't stop this bolt of lightning even if you tried. If someone comes for you, if someone tries to get you, provoke you to react, I just say take a deep breath, breathe, stretch, shake, let it go, ground yourself, center. What you can control is how you react to certain things, and it's almost like rolling the dice. You don't know what's going to come in. It's so unpredictable. You just don't. So if that's the case, I just say, you know, examine. That's the thing about the Seven of Pentacles, is that it's very slow and methodical. It's a slow, deliberate, intentional examination of what it is that's happening around you. And that just covers Monday through Wednesday. So instead of reacting to what kind of comes in and what kind of news comes in and brings light to certain situations, because I'm also seeing these cards, it's just examine it, watch it. If you're shocked by it, allow yourself to experience the shock, allow yourself to feel what you're feeling, and then move forward accordingly. If there is a direct cut that you need to make, and it's very obvious choice, then that's what it is that you have to do. Sometimes the universe has an interesting way of shocking us so that we can see the truth for what it is, and I'm seeing a lot of that happening this week, so I wouldn't be surprised. So definitely keep me posted as the day unfolds, or as the week unfolds. Now, the second portion of this week is Wednesday through Friday is how I cover this energy. And basically with this, what it is that I'm seeing is the Seven of Swords and the Five of Cups. Now, what I feel with this, and we're seeing the Moon card again, is that there is a lot of information that wants to reveal itself, or that will present itself at the very end, well, this middle of this week, so Wednesday through Friday. But Wednesday through Friday, it's almost like word of mouth, or you heard it through the grapevine, these like little annoying things or these little irritating bits of information that kind of irritate you, but there's truth to it. It triggers you. It kind of unveils a truth. It kind of unveils a bit of information. Maybe it's something that you heard. Maybe it's something someone said. Maybe it's gossip. Maybe it's a conversation. Maybe you were out and about and you kind of saw something over there that kind of revealed that there's something else that was going on that was hidden to you or hidden from you, and that kind of highlights a little bit more information. Maybe that's why there's a shock and awe. Again, this energy is very irritable. So basically what it is that I'm seeing is that people are a little reckless, and because they're reckless, they're going to do reckless things that put them in positions where they are not careful. So their secrets or what they've been doing kind of falls out. It kind of is out there. Maybe someone is restless and they go out. They go out for a night out, or they drink too much. This is very Mars, you know, moving through Leo type energy, and then the emotions are involved with the Sun and Venus moving through the sign of Cancer, and Mercury retrograde being like kind of spilling the tea and revealing a little bit more than you were expecting to, and then Jupiter squaring off with Neptune doing the most. There's a lot going on here, but whatever it is, something is said, something is revealed, something stumbles out, something is discovered, and it can create some emotional disappointment. What used to be a fantasy is no longer a fantasy. Maybe this isn't necessarily a bad thing. Maybe this is, okay, I've been holding this on my chest. I've been holding this on my heart. It's been annoying me. It's been plaguing me. And now I'm finally going to tell the truth. I'm going to reveal it. I'm going to make it known. But either way, it's almost like someone is in the shower and they rip back the shower curtain, and it's just like, ha, I'm here, completely naked, completely nude. This is my truth. This is my reality. And it's either pretty or it's not, but it is what it is. So that's what I'm seeing Wednesday through Friday. Again, word of mouth, what was hidden is now revealed. It's something that could be that could present itself while you're out and about, while you're socializing, while you're engaging with others, whatever the case is. All right, mark my words. Mark my words. Friday through Sunday, the weekend. This is interesting because I saw this question of, now I see where your loyalties lie. Now I see where I need to commit myself to, where I need to rest myself. Like, now I see what I can trust, what I can count on, what is always going to be there for me. I'm going to ground myself. I'm going to center myself here, because now I know all that has happened. And now that I'm seeing all that has happened, that's really giving me power. That is really giving me guidance and protection. I am calling in my personal power. I am stepping into my own authority. I'm going to be my own spiritual leader. I'm going to rely on myself. I'm going to call on myself. I am not going to stoop to a lower level. I'm going to approach this with compassion and wisdom. I'm not going to compromise my reputation or my morals for this lower vibration or this lower energy. I am going to rise above it all. Whatever it is what I'm going to choose to rise above. So again, Friday and Sunday, it's interesting because you might be partnering up with someone, or someone that it is that you know that you can trust, that you can trust and that you can count on, that you know is a safe space, that you can drop your anchor and know that they will be there, and then maybe tell them what's been going on and get it off of your chest. So I'm definitely seeing that. And this is, again, someone that you can trust, someone that you can always count on, that has been there for you. Or maybe it's not always there, but it could be a friend, a new friend that you can talk to, that you can tell, and they will hold your truth. They will hold your feelings and protect them. Or maybe it's you, maybe it's a journal or something. I'm just seeing, you know, getting it out and talking about it, and then also seeing, okay, now I see where your loyalties are. Now I see where it is that I'm committing myself to. And for that, I'm gonna link up, I'm gonna partner up. We can build into the future. I can see the potential. It's not so much these annoying, plaguing things. And I know that someone's on my side. Like, I can build, I can envision, I can see this thing happening now, especially as we're nearing towards the end, which in the weekend, we're getting closer and closer to the lunar eclipse that is going to be happening that following week. And that's going to really highlight a lot of things. And of course, I'll have a video up for you guys on that. So that's something to keep an eye out for and to look towards. One thing that I want to talk to you guys about is, because you guys know I do strengths and weaknesses for this week. One of the ways to work with weaknesses this week is through magic, ritual, and intention. And for some reason, the word dark mother came through, and it's that dark womb energy of, okay, I don't need to birth something right now because something is actually being created and it will birth all by itself. That's why we want to be open to change, not resistant to change, because there's a lot that is being created here. There's a lot that's starting to seed and starting to grow. And because it's so new, we don't know what it's going to be. This is like when there's a baby and it's growing in the womb, and you know that it's a child in there because it, you know, the pregnancy test came up positive, but you don't know if it's a boy or a girl. That's kind of where we're at right now. Like, we don't know if it's a boy or a girl. We don't know if it has all 10 fingers, all 10 toes. We're hoping for the best. We're hoping for what we're hoping for, but we don't know yet until the results are in. And that's ultimately kind of what it is that I'm seeing all this week, is you can't really jump and make a move until you know everything. So instead of reacting, wait, pause. And that's back to what it was that I'm seeing as far as a weakness here, is the weakness is being in a space of nothingness, you know. And sometimes it's really hard for people to be still. We just talked about that. And earlier on in my meditation this morning, the word resurrection came through. Something is being resurrected, something is being born from the old, from the ash, and new life is coming with that, but it takes time to develop. While it is developing, you can set your intention. I know that the lunar eclipse is happening next week, but I'm really seeing a strong pull for people to set intention, to pray, to do ritual now this week. And it's all about what is being cooked right now. If there is energy that is being cooked, and there's energy that is developing and being created, go ahead and feel free to put your intention in that, because your intention gets included in what the magic is going to ultimately look like and what is going to manifest. Do I see you forcing your will and forcing your way? No, because there needs to be enough flexibility that you are open to what the universe is also trying to bring in. You need to be fearless. You need to be courageous. And as I'm saying this, I look Frida Kahlo dead in her eyes just now when she's moving from her heart. Even no matter what it is that she's going through, no matter how much pain and suffering she's in, she always pulls from a space of strength within her, regardless of what is happening within her heart, what is happening within her body, what is happening around her. She always pulls from her strength. And that's ultimately what it is that I'm seeing for all of us. The other thing that is working for us is I'm seeing glass being held, and I'm seeing it break. I'm seeing it shatter. And this is the shattering of the illusion. It's the shatter of the mirror, the reflection of who I thought I was, the shatter of what I thought this was. So now I can see things clear. It's no longer, if you look at a mirror, you're looking at the reflection of something, and the reflection is just a reflection. It's not actual real. You're not looking at something that is tangible. You know, if you're looking at a mirror and you see a face there, you can't touch that face and be like, okay, that's a face. It's only a reflection. You're gonna be touching the mirror. When the mirror drops and the glass breaks, you can see that this is no longer an illusion. This is no longer a reflection. Because of that, you can now see things differently and look towards other things. And that's what I'm seeing as a strength, is that when this shattering happens, when this is revealed, when the choice is called for you to make it, you will then know what it is that you need to do next. But even in that space, as things are revealing themselves, as they shatter left and right, or maybe one thing, or maybe multiple things, it's helping to put you in a space where you have the truth so that you can call the shots on what is for your highest and greatest good. But instead of reacting right now, we're going to ground ourselves, we are going to center ourselves, and we are going to stay in a space of trust and co-creation and allowing the universe to do what it's going to do, because it's going to do it regardless. So I need to change my contacts. I need to take a break. I'm going to get this video up there for you, and then I'm going to move forward and kind of relax because it's Mercury retrograde. We're going to finish packing up your orders because some of you guys are still waiting, and I appreciate your patience. Yeah, I think I just answered. Okay, perfect. Okay, so that's pretty much what it is that I'm seeing, you guys. Keep me posted. I know that I'm wordy right now. That's usual. I don't know where all of this energy has been coming from, because I had coffee this morning, but it was way earlier this morning. But I did a reading for someone, and we did an energy exchange, and we were doing magic, and I think that magic, like, I just feel the energy from that just still surging through my body. And I remember even while we were sitting there, I was like, this is weird. The way that I feel right now is like electricity. So I'm definitely feeling that. If you guys feel that, then that's where I'm at right now. That is the truth. Magic is everything. Intention is everything. We weren't even trying. It just kind of happened. I don't hate it, but I am going to take a shower. I am going to reset, and I'm going to go to my altar, and I'm going to call the shots on some important things. Okay? So that being said, I'm going to go ahead and sign off, and make sure that you're subscribed to this YouTube channel. Make sure that you leave comments and you keep me posted on what is going on in your life, that we keep this conversation, this dialogue open and continuing, because I'm always doing my research. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.